It rained on the slopes of El Yunque. There were tears on the shore of San Juan. And some folk did pray on that dark New Year's Day, 'cause Roberto Clemente was gone. Though he stood without equal in baseball, on this trip he carried no glove. He owned 4 batting crowns, but when death brought him down, he was flying a mission of love. If you know Chance and Evers and Tinker, the Sultan of SWAT, the Big Train, time you add to that lore one whose name stands for more than success at an old summer game. Roberto first learned to play baseball with a mitt made from coffee bean sacks. A ball? No one had. So they rolled up a rag, and a guava tree limb was their bat. To run, throw, and hit made him happy. Of baseball, he never could tire. Once he stayed out so long that his supper was gone, and mommy tossed his best bat in the fire. But nothing could stop this young actor. He'd leap for fly balls till it hurt. When his schoolwork was done, to the diamond he would run to perform on the grass and the dirt. Roberto was finishing high school as news of his talent spread round, till a scout came one day and signed him to play for the Crabbers from Santurce town. And soon he belonged to the Dodgers, who shipped him to cold Montreal. And they never explained that his skin, not his game, had trapped him in AAA ball. Brooklyn had stepped across that racial line. Jackie Robinson now was a star. But Clemente in right would mean more black than white. And the owners weren't going that far. They never intended to keep him, but only to keep him away from a franchise they feared and an outfield speared by a young center fielder named Mays.
What a catch by Willie Mays!
So Pittsburgh, the last place town, took him. And how'd he pay off? None could guess. Could the Dodger brass know while letting him go that each year he'd hit their pitchers best? Though sports writers garbled his English, he made himself clear with his bat. When the ball thunked on wood, Pirate fans understood, and they got 18 seasons of that. He'd beat a slow roller to shortstop, and next time he'd slam one to right. And God only knew what a pitcher could do if he'd learn how to wait for a strike.
That pitch looked like it'd be about a foot outside, Chuck.
He never was known for the long ball, but give him 2 out and 1 on, and the Bucks are run down. You think he won't go downtown? Just ask Koufax, or Gibson, or Spawn. Most splendid of all was his fielding. His right arm a cannon with grace. None but fools dared to run on that merciless gun. And but a few lived to touch second base. But always, the press found him wanting. A hot dog who loved to complain. And they never did right how he sat up all night, 'cause his body was twisted with pain. The doctors who treated his ailments knew he played when he should have sat down. And they'd seen the man slip from malaria's grip and fight back for his 3rd batting crown. At last, he was given his platform, the series of 71. But that Oriole team was a well-oiled machine, and his Pirates were thought to be done. To Palmer, McNally, and Crazy Horse Cuellar, with 62 wins in their caps, they had none to compare but Doc Ellis's stare and the grit of a moundsman named Blass. But those 20-win aces were helpless against the one who first swung at a rag. And on balls hit to right, the birds couldn't take flight, as their fleetest were beat by the tag.
And here with me right now, the greatest right fielder in the game of baseball, Roberto Clemente. Bobby, congratulations on a great World Series.
Thank you, Bob. And before I say anything in English, I would like to say something for my mother and father in Spanish.
The moment belonged to Clemente. As cameras proceeded to roll, they asked for his thoughts, and the millions who watched heard him answer in plain Espanol. Mamá y papá, soy tu hijo. I ask for your blessing this day. And the strength of his words silenced all but the birds, chirping salsa round Chesapeake Bay. The world now joined Puerto Rico in honoring one of her sons, as with new peace of mind, he went home to unwind, unaware his last winter had come. He could still go like smoke on the base paths.
Matlack on the 0-1. Bobby hits a dive into the gap in left center field. There she is.
But other paths beckoned him too. He lived for much more than tomorrow's box score. To his dreams, he would always be true. He worked on a plan called Sports City, where kids would be treated like kings. They'd eat the best meals. They'd play on new fields. They'd wrestle, they'd race, and they'd sing. One treacherous night in Managua, the earth rearranged its outsides and tossed families around and pulled walls to the ground. And by morning, 6,000 had died. For 6 days, he crossed Puerto Rico for blankets and food and supplies. Then a small private plane he quickly obtained, and a party of five organized. Three boys said, "Good night, papito," not knowing his legend was sealed. As the sea and the sand swallowed up that good man who could never be stopped on the field. And so passed Roberto Clemente, who scaled enough walls in his time, from the sugarcane fields to a city of steel. To the end, he continued to climb.
Roberto, Clemente, tú nos enseñaste a ser como hermanos con tu bondad.